Morning, YouTube. It's about 7:30 a.m. here, and we're about to get started milling. Still set up from yesterday. Got a nice red oak log on the mill here. It's 12 foot in length and 26 on the big end. Got quite a taper to it, unfortunately, so we're gonna have a bit of waste. And 19, yeah, that is quite a bit of taper. 19 on the small end. Looks to be clear for the most part. There we go. Looks to be clear for the most part. Didn't see any signs of metal. Always keep my fingers crossed there. Last few days, no metal at all. You notice the white oak logs are slowly disappearing. We had two stacks here, they're gone. The 2x8s of the not so nice looking oak, white oak. Trailer decking, tabletops, whatever guys decide to use them for, but they're here. 8-quarter, yep. More of it over here, more of the same. I get requests for trailer decking, so it's nice to have some on hand. It's a big stack of hickory yet to go. I sold up one of these yesterday, a small one. This stuff's gonna eat my blades. These are 7-degree turbos. They turn out really nice. Hey, there's an idea for you if you don't do this. Portable, when you're portable and you're going out in the field. I packed this tote full of some spare parts, some tools. Everything I need to mill. Safety glasses, goggles, dust masks, wire brushes, oils, things like that, extra gloves. It's an all-around good thing to have with you. Pack it all in one tote, load to tote, you're ready to go. Got my crates full of blocks for leveling. We'll be working out of this stack here. There's only four of these. There's two fairly clear ones. One on the mill and one on the top here, and then two not so clear. Probably end up slabbing those. We'll see. Got a couple customers stopping by today. One is picking up, they want some 4x4s. So they want five of them, 5 feet long. So we've got three of them, and we'll be cutting those down into what they need, cutting them lengthwise. Those are like 11 and a half feet long. And another one stopped by yesterday. It's the first time I've done this, as I cut cookies out of the logs they brought up. So we cut them and sealed them yesterday. They've been sitting, letting the sealer dry on them. And I think there's like 40 of them here total. But they'll be picking those up this morning. Oh, what else? Oh, yeah. I mentioned this skidding rig before in the past. That I use on the back of my little Kubota tractor here. Let's get a look at this. Really simple. This was a V-plow, single row V-plow. This used to be on the bottom down here. Cut it off, flipped it over to get some height out of this. Like I said, just a quick fab job. Couldn't figure out a way to hang this off of there real quick without another chunk of steel to weld on there. So there were some bolt holes for the plow. We bolted the chain piece on there. Hooked the skidding tongs to it. Does a good job, 1,200 pounds lifting force. And stance the tractor up every once in a while. Just put some counterweight in the bucket and you're off and going again. Like I said, this tractor has done much more than it should have. Little Kubota BX1500. That's how we move a lot of the heavier things around here. But let's get this mill uncovered and get to sawing. Thank you. Well, the mill's warming up. It's just a little bit of what we cut yesterday. Again, white oak. This is our FAS stack. It's supposed to be zero defects in here. No knots, nothing, completely clear. This is our 1A, I guess they call it. Number 1C, 1C, and 2AC mixed in there. It was that single hickory log we cut yesterday. I'm going to save the outer cuts of this for local guys who love to use it in the smokers. Hickory smoked meat, nothing better. All right, well, let's get to work on this bad boy here and make some nice clear red oak lumber. Thank you. Okay, I just got to show this off a little bit. These planks are coming out. Nice and wide. And super clear. They are. About 14 inches wide. And clear as a bell. Beautiful red oak. Clear from one end to the other. So we've got some nice lumber coming out of this tree. And another shot of the next board. Again. 14 inches wide. Clear from one end to the other. Definitely FAS red oak. Beautiful stuff. Hopefully you can catch us in the, hopefully the video is catching this. Beautiful red oak. All right, let's get back at it. I just had to show you some of that beautiful grain in there. Let's turn some more good boards out. You know, I hate when that happens. I have a active 911 app on my phone for my response with our local ambulance squad. It acts as a pager, so I don't have to carry a pager and a cell phone. Anyway, that's what shut off the video suddenly. But here we have, on this side, this is our not so good lumber, let's call it. This is our FAS stack here, which turned out to be pretty nice. We got a lot of good stuff out of that log. So that yielded quite a bit of good lumber. It was a nice butt log with zero knots in it until you got well to the inside of the log. So again, our white oak lumber there. Here's where we're headed over here next. I'm gonna grab this one off the top right here, that one. It's sapwood's soft, so we'll be getting some junk off the outside. Looks like some spalting in there too. But you can see that sapwood in about an inch or so, and that'll all go to the scrap pile more than likely. But let's get it moved and get back to sawing. All right, let's demonstrate that little skidding rig we got on the back of the tractor so we can get this other one loaded up. Thank you. And there you have it.
That's how that little rig works. I said the rear end of that three-point hitch will pick up 1,200 pounds, so dragging some of these oak logs is not an issue. Now, I can't say the same for those big hickory logs. They'll roll, but I can't drag them with that. I can't pick them up. They're just too heavy. Even one end. It just, I don't have the clearance, and two, I don't think I have the lifting capability. So let me go help her get this log loaded, and we'll get back to sawing, all right?
Well, all of the white oak is cut to 4/4. At least this stuff is, anyway. This is our 2A stack.
Although, some of this stuff is a lot clearer than 2A. Or, I'm sorry. What do they call it? 1C? 1A? I don't know. It's graded out. Either way. This is the mixed grade. The not clear stuff. Although, a little quarter inch pinhole knot, or a pin knot, keeps it from being FAS, which is what this stack is. It's all of our FAS stacked and stickered. The longest ones are 12 feet long on the bottom. Unfortunately, my pallets are only about 10 feet long, so they've got to overhang a little bit. Hopefully, I don't get any sag there on the ends. And it goes down in size from there. These two pallets have to be covered yet. And about a year from now, they'll be ready to go. Some of our other lumber over here, we've got 4 5/4. No, that's all 4/4 red oak. All but two layers of that are FAS. That was some beautiful stuff coming out of that tree. I remember that one. Here's a couple layers of 4/4, and the rest is 5/4 mixed grade on this. Back here we've got some cherry and some more red oak, 5/4 mixed. We've got some white oak live edge, a little bit of quarter sawn oak under the brown tarp in the middle. Let's walk around down here. We've got our miscellaneous live edge slabs all stacked and stickered in there.
Still got more of those to bring out here. This big black tarp here is all slippery elm or red elm, same tree.
And there's that red oak I mentioned. Red oak and cherry there. White oak live edge. All the way over here is live edge, red oak mostly on that stack. That is ash, 4/4, 5/4, 5/4 ash, and there's our pallets waiting for more lumber to come back. So keeping busy.
Still have not gotten to these two black walnut logs yet.
Can't wait to get into those. I'm sure there's going to be some nice clear lumber in those. Both of those are butt logs.
But we're looking forward to getting those opened up and having some quality black walnut around.
Still have our live edge slabs back here. We've got to get off the patio.
Black walnut, cherry,
white oak, and such back here. And we started digging into our stack of 700 plus stickers.
And we're going to be probably going to end up cutting some more soon. I'm going to be out of these by the time we're done cutting all the lumber we need to cut.
I haven't even touched any of these yet.
In fact, I've added to these. I gotta get these two little hickory logs out of here. A lot of live edge slab pieces to get done in here. Including this big maple. I'm almost guaranteeing that's full of spalting and some really nice grain. Looking forward to opening that up as well.
Out of all the stacks we had along here, The last one here is the hickory. Any suggestions on milling hickory, I'm all for it. The last time I cut it, the stuff just wanted to go everywhere. That should be the last of the stuff I cut in the trailer decking. All 8/4 white oak there. And there's all of our slabs. That's actually sold. Somebody grabbed that as we were milling. They came over, asked us what we wanted for it, gave me a price, they paid it. They'll be here later on in the week to pick it up. So we don't have to mess with that. Our only live edge slab we did this milling weekend. White oak log, all full of knots, whatnot. Figure, I got a picture in here somewhere of a set of these bookmatched laying out. I'll have to throw that in this video somewhere. That's got to get stacked and stickered out back. And our red oak, both the FAS here and here, I think, and the, no, this is FAS here, sorry, wrong pile. That is the lower grade stuff, and I mean, you look at it, you wouldn't think lower grade. That's the only thing that keeps it from being FAS is one knot. So, still good stuff. And the one hickory log got mixed into the batch. I mean, that's just all sapwood on the outside there, but see some of the darker stuff starting to show up, and there's more dark as you go down into the stack, so. But that's not going anywhere soon. That's gonna get stacked in with the rest of this stuff. Well, that was our weekend of milling. I'm gonna get started again. I'll probably start milling as soon as tomorrow. As long as the weather's holding out, we're gonna be milling, I think. We can get all caught up on all this stuff. So we've got some jobs to do away from here. Customers got us coming out to, I think there's 3 or 4 different jobs lined up right now, so. Plenty of work waiting for us. This is all of our trailer decking again. White oak. Well, I call it, like I said before, I call it trailer decking, but hey. Also makes tables. One of the few things I cut to actual dimensions 2x8s. That seems to be what the guys went for trailer decking, so if it does go for that, it's already cut. So that about does it for the weekend. Time to head out for dinner. Well-earned and well-deserved dinner. Just the wife and I tonight. And hopefully you guys like the videos that are coming out. If you do, again, like, share, subscribe, and see what we can keep sending out to y'all. Okay? Take care. We'll see you next time. Good morning, YouTube. It's about 7:30 a.m. here. And we're about to get started milling. Still set up from yesterday. Got a nice red oak log on the mill here. It's 12 foot in length and 26 on the big end. It's got quite a taper to it, unfortunately. So we're gonna have a bit of waste. And 19, yeah, that is quite a bit of taper. 19 on the small end. Looks to be clear for the most part. There we go, looks to be clear for the most part. Didn't see any signs of metal. Always keep my fingers crossed there. Last few days, no metal at all. You notice the white oak logs are slowly disappearing. We had 2 stacks here, they're gone. The 2x8s of the not so nice looking oak, white oak. Trailer decking. Tabletops, whatever guys decide to use them for, but they're here. 8/4, yep. More of it over here, more of the same. I get requests for trailer decking, so it's nice to have some on hand.
big stack of hickory yet to go. I sold up one of these yesterday, a small one. This stuff's gonna eat my blades. These the 7-degree turbos. They turn out really nice. Hey, there's an idea for you, is if you don't do this. Portable, when you're portable and you're going out in the field. I packed this tote full of some spare parts, some tools, everything I need to mill. Safety glasses, goggles, dust masks, wire brushes, oils, things like that, extra gloves. It's an all-around good thing to have with you. Pack it all in one tote, load the tote, you're ready to go. Got my crates full of blocks for leveling. We'll be working out of this stack here. There's only four of these. There's two fairly clear ones. One on the mill and one on the top here. And then two not so clear. Probably end up slabbing those. We'll see. Had a couple customers stopping by today. One is picking up. They want some 4x4s. So they want five of them, 5 feet long. So we've got three of them, and we'll be cutting those down into what they need, cutting them lengthwise. Those are like 11 and a half feet long. And another one stopped by yesterday. It's the first time I've done this, as I cut cookies out of the logs they brought up. So we cut them and sealed them yesterday. They've been sitting, letting the sealer dry on them. And I think there's like 40 of them here total. But they'll be picking those up this morning. Oh, what else? Oh, yeah. I mentioned a skidding rig before in the past that I use on the back of my little Kubota tractor here. Let's get a look at this. Really simple. This was a V-plow, single row V-plow. This used to be on the bottom down here. Cut it off, flipped it over to get some height out of this. And like I said, just a quick fab job. Couldn't figure out a way to hang this off of there real quick without another chunk of steel to weld on there. So there were some bolt holes for the plow. We bolted the chain piece on there. Hooked the skidding tongs to it. Does a good job, 1,200 pounds lifting force. And stands the tractor up every once in a while. Just put some counterweight in the bucket and you're off and going again. I said this tractor has done much more than it should have. Little Kubota BX1500. That's how we move a lot of the heavier things around here. But let's get this mill uncovered and get the sawing. Thank you. while the mill's warming up, it's just a little bit of what we cut yesterday. Again, white oak. This is our FAS stack. It's supposed to be zero defects in here. No knots, nothing, completely clear. This is our 1A, I guess they call it. Number 1C, 1C, and 2AC mixed in there. There's that single hickory log we cut yesterday. I'm going to save the outer cuts of this for local guys who love to use it in the smokers. Hickory smoked meat, nothing better. All right, well, let's get to work on this bad boy here and make some nice clear red oak lumber. Thank you. Okay, I just got to show this off a little bit. These planks are coming out. Nice and wide. And super clear. They are. About 14 inches wide. And clear as a bell. Beautiful red oak. Clear from one end to the other. So we've got some nice lumber coming out of this tree. And another shot of the next board. Again. 14 inches wide. Clear from one end to the other. Definitely FAS red oak. Beautiful stuff. Hopefully you can catch us in the hopefully the video is catching this. Beautiful red oak. Alright, let's get back at it. I just had to show you some of that beautiful grain in there. Let's turn some more good boards out.
Thank you.
You know, I hate when that happens. I have a active 911 app on my phone for my response with our local ambulance squad. It acts as a pager, so I don't have to carry a pager and a cell phone. Anyway, that's what shut off the video suddenly. But here we have, on this side, this is our not-so-good lumber, let's call it. This is our FAS stack here, which turned out to be pretty nice. We got a lot of good stuff out of that log. So, that yielded quite a bit of good lumber. It was a nice butt log with zero knots in it until you got well to the inside of the log. So, again, our white oak lumber there. Here's where we're headed over here next. I'm going to grab this one off the top right here. That one. It's sapwood's soft, so we'll be getting some junk off the outside. Looks like some spalting in there too. But you can see that sapwood in about an inch or so, and that'll all go to the scrap pile more than likely. But let's get it moved and get back to sawing. All right, let's demonstrate that little skidding rig we got on the back of the tractor so we can get this other one loaded up. Thank you. And there you have it. That's how that little rig works. I said the rear end of that three-point hitch will pick up 1,200 pounds, so dragging some of these oak logs is not an issue. Now, I can't say the same for those big hickory logs. They'll roll, but I can't drag them with that. I can't pick them up. They're just too heavy. Even one end. It just, I don't have the clearance, and two, I don't think I have the lifting capability. So let me go help her get this log loaded, and we'll get back to sawing, all right? Well, all of the white oak is cut to 4/4, at least this stuff is anyway. This is our 2A stack. Although some of this stuff is a lot clearer than 2A. Or, I'm sorry, what do they call it? 1C? 1A? I don't know. It's graded out. Either way. This is the mixed grade. The not clear stuff, although a little quarter inch pinhole knot or pin knot keeps it from being FAS, which is what this stack is. It's all of our FAS stacked and stickered. The longest ones are 12 feet long on the bottom. Unfortunately, my pallets are only a little about 10 feet long, so it's got to overhang a little bit. Hopefully, I don't get any sag there on the ends. And it goes down in size from there. These two pallets have to be covered yet. And about a year from now, they'll be ready to go. Some of our other lumber over here have got 4 5/4. No, that's all 4/4 red oak. All but two layers of that are FAS. That was some beautiful stuff coming out of that tree. I remember that one. Here's a couple layers of 4/4, and the rest is 5/4 mixed grade on this. Back here we've got some cherry and some more red oak, 5/4 mixed. We've got some white oak live edge, a little bit of quarter sawn oak under the brown tarp in the middle. Let's walk around down here. We've got our miscellaneous live edge slabs all stacked and stickered in there. Still got more of those to bring out here. This big black tarp here is all slippery elm or red elm, same tree. And there's that red oak I mentioned. Red oak and cherry there. White oak live edge. All the way over here is live edge, red oak mostly on that stack. That is ash, 4/4, 5/4, 5/4 ash, and there's our pallets waiting for more lumber to come back, so keeping busy. Still have not gotten to these two black walnut logs yet. Can't wait to get into those. I'm sure there's going to be some nice clear lumber in those. Both of those are butt logs. But we're looking forward to getting those opened up and having some quality black walnut around. Still have our live edge slabs back here. We've got to get off the patio. Black walnut, cherry, white oak, and such back here. And we started digging into our stack of 700 plus stickers. And we're going to be probably going to end up cutting some more soon. I'm going to be out of these by the time we're done cutting all the lumber we need to cut. Haven't even touched any of these yet. In fact, I've added to these. I gotta get these two little hickory logs out of here. A lot of live edge slab pieces to get done in here, including this big maple. I'm almost guaranteeing that's full of spalting and some really nice grain.
Looking forward to opening that up as well.
Out of all the stacks we had along here, the last one here is the hickory. Any suggestions on milling hickory, I'm all for it. The last time I cut it, the stuff just wanted to go everywhere. That should be the last of the stuff I cut in the trailer decking. All 8/4 white oak there. And there's all of our slabs. That's actually sold. Somebody grabbed that as we were milling. They came over, asked us what we wanted for it, gave them a price, they paid it. They'll be here later on in the week to pick it up. So we don't have to mess with that. Our only live edge slab we did this milling weekend. White oak log, all full of knots, whatnot. Figure, I got a picture in here somewhere of a set of these book matched laying out. I'll have to throw that in this video somewhere. That's got to get stacked and stickered out back. And our red oak, both the FAS here and here, I think. And the, no, this is FAS here. Sorry, wrong pile. That is the lower grade stuff. And I mean, you look at it, you wouldn't think lower grade. That's the only thing that keeps it from being FAS is one knot. So, still good stuff. And the one hickory log got mixed into the batch. I mean, that's just all sapwood on the outside there, but see some of the darker stuff starting to show up, and there's more dark as you go down into the stack, so. But that's not going anywhere soon. That's gonna get stacked in with the rest of this stuff. Well, that was our weekend of milling. Gonna get started again. I'll probably start milling as soon as tomorrow. As long as the weather's holding out, we're gonna be milling, I think. So we can get all caught up on all this stuff. Because we've got some jobs to do away from here. Customers got us coming out to, I think there's 3 or 4 different jobs lined up right now, so. Plenty of work waiting for us. This is all of our trailer decking again. White oak. Well, I call it, like I said before, I call it trailer decking, but hey. Also makes tables. One of the few things I cut to actual dimensions, 2x8s. That seems to be what the guys want for trailer decking, so if it does go for that, it's already cut. So that about does it for the weekend. Time to head out for dinner. Well-earned and well-deserved dinner. Just the wife and I tonight. And hopefully you guys like the videos that are coming out. If you do, again, like, share, subscribe, and see what we can keep sending out to y'all. Okay? Take care. We'll see you next time.